we can. What?
Welcome to Taskmaster. I'm Greg Davies, and I am the Taskmaster. And I mean the real one, not the comic book villain that pops up when you Google me. We've both got our skills. He can mimic any fighting style, and I can take down an 18-inch pizza in one by unhooking my jaw like a mighty human snake. Delicious. And I'm the only Taskmaster that wields power over trophy-hungry comedians. They are my Fantastic Five, and they are ready to save the world by being rubbish at tasks. So please welcome Dara Breen, Fan Brady, John Kearns, Munya Chawawa, and Sarah Millican. And next to me is someone who I can be a little bit cruel to, but at the end of the day, I'm proud to call my best friend. It's Tronky, the naughty elephant. Love you, Tronky. And next to him, a wretched hairy weasel. Little Alex Horne! What are we going to chat about this week?
Well, I've got a really funny story. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
Well, yesterday, I got a piggyback.
Yep.
Because I'd lent my piggy to my uncle, and then he gave it back to me.
Gave you the piggy back to me.
So I got my piggy back. It's a funny story.
Prize task then. What's the category? I'll tell you, Alex. It's the best thing you nearly keep throwing away but can't quite bring yourself to. I'll give 5 points for the best one, and the winner of the episode will get to take them all home and keep them all forever. And that is how replaceable you are. Munya!
I have bought in my first ever houseplant.
Ooh, that bodes badly.
Go on. So, as we know, a houseplant is a good metric of how much of an adult you are. You know, if you can keep a plant, you can keep a puppy. If you keep a puppy, you can keep a child. You know, it's like the Royal Marines advert. So, I said to myself, if I can keep this alive, I'm going to be a better man. So I spent 40 quid. I named him Young Pablo. He died after a week. I realised that, kind of like your nan, if you move it about every once in a while, give it a bit of water, it won't completely die. So, what I have managed to do is keep Young Pablo alive for 5 years, but on the brink of death.
Would you like to see Young Pablo now? Someone is going to win this. Not about prize on a quiz.
But it bodes well for your future children. Dara, can you beat a plant that's barely alive?
Yeah, I can give you a thing that should be alive but is now dead. And is a section of my leg.
They're impressed. What do you mean?
Part of my leg broke off during a football match and had to be removed, and then they give it to you.
A part of your leg just snapped off?
It broke off, and then, because I'm nails, I pushed it back in again and carried on playing.
Save my balls, go up inside myself.
Oh, do you want me to...
No. Let's have a look at a bit of Dara's bone.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh.
Strong, Dara.
I, by the way, I've kept my tonsils. People do.
Yeah?
Yeah, they're still in my...
Fern.
I want my house to look like something out of Architectural Digest, and my boyfriend wants it to look like something out of Steptoe and Son. So it's this dirty, disgusting tanker, and he uses it to keep toothbrushes inside. I have tried to sort of sneakily throw it out before.
So if you do badly, I'm doing you a favour.
Yeah, what happens if I do badly? Do you take it away from me?
It means if you do badly, someone else gets to win it and keep it now.
Yes, let's do that.
John.
I bought in Ulysses by James Joyce. I've had that for about 20 years. Never read it.
Do you think tonally you've got this wrong?
No, because It's the best piece of literature ever written, so it's one of the best things I've ever seen. Yep. But I have ambition to read it, so I'll never throw it out.
Yeah. I think I'm surprised, because I'm expecting there to be a twist.
Well, there might be. I haven't read it. I don't know.
Sarah?
Hi.
Can you definitely beat John's book?
I don't know. That's up to you to decide.
Oh, I already have.
It's my husband's zombie.
Here it is.
Oh. It's 6 foot tall. And frightens the shit out of me twice a week, maybe. It's awful. Please take it away.
Maybe you could clear a little room and let that be his special room.
It is in his special room.
Oh.
It's called the zombie room. So it's hard to throw her away when she's in her own room.
Well, Greg, it's quite a haul of prizes tonight for someone.
Do you want me to go from John upwards or the other way?
Second book in a row, second 1 point in a row. Hello, John.
Yeah, yeah. I feel pretty much the same about a mug and a zombie. 3 points each.
OK, 3 points each to Fern and Sarah.
That's right. And then I jump up. Oh. Unbelievably, I'm putting a half-dead plant in second place just because I liked all the flannel that went with it. And if anyone brings part of their body that just fell off them in, I mean, for sympathy more than anything, they get 5 points.
5 points to Dora Breen.
There it is! Right, what's lined up for the first task, Alex?
Well, Greg, it's only the king of all stationary items.
Should we say it together?
Yes. One, two, three... A laminator!
Can you see me?
Yeah, there
should
you are.
I feel like we should do, like, an action movie intro. What do you think?
Yes, please.
What did I miss?
Hello, Munya.
Say something like, you know, I'm glad you're here or something.
Well, I'm glad you're here.
Oh! Print, laminate and distribute the most signs.
Each of your signs must be placed on a different seat.
And all your signs must have a different instruction.
You have 20 minutes.
And your time starts now. How long does it take to laminate a sign, or what size does the sign have to be? Is there a standard size for laminated signs?
I used to work in my dad's office, and he docked some of my wages because he had a laminating machine. And I laminated love letters to my ex-boyfriend. Good times.
Fern, it feels like I probably shouldn't ask, but why were you laminating letters to your ex-boyfriend?
They were love letters, and by laminating it, I felt like it showed that I really meant what I was saying.
Yeah, I mean, I agree. My family motto is print, laminate, distribute.
OK, let's go.
Let's see. OK, well, first up, it's Fern, John and Dara.
So we start off with a simple one. Don't sit down.
Turn your phone to silent. I mean, anything's an instruction, isn't it?
It's just blanked out the document. Now the document's gone to tiny font. This is what? I don't. What?
It's quite nice to look at fonts now and then.
Yeah. What font have you gone for?
I've always liked Georgia.
Where's print? There's a picture of a printer somewhere. Is that how these things work?
So you're looking for a picture of a printer?
I'm looking for a picture of a printer. Changes the diary invite. Where's print?
I haven't seen some of these fonts since I was about 10. Joker Man. Look at this.
What's that thing middle-aged women have on signs? Live, laugh, gin.
That's the size of the sign I just made.
I can't actually read it. What does it say?
It says, you have, the instructions are quite clear. The instructions are on the sign. First sign, right, first sign, so there's a sign. It's not laminated!
Right, Wingdings.
I feel so productive, even though this is very silly.
Do these things separate? They separate! The factory is now open.
Do you know what that says? Bums only. I can't remember what the other two meant.
I don't remember typing leave your husband, so I've written some of these in a fugue state.
Thank you, Dara.
Hold up, there's two that say warm your bum. That says warm your bum. How have I done that three times?
Hello, Fern.
Hello.
That's for you as well. A little something extra.
Obey all your signs.
Highest percentage of signs obeyed wins.
You have 3 minutes. Your time starts now.
Good luck.
Well, I can't.
Okay.
Watch out for burglars. Burglars. I thought you were kidnappers.
Well, that's your seat. So could you sit there? The Joker man's seat. So we'll wait for him to turn up.
Eat 25 grams fibre a day starting from now. Where's my sandwich for lunch?
Munchak deer. Oh, tigers. The Gruffalo.
Yeah, I mean, I've walked straight into this now, haven't I? Because I don't remember what that says.
Breathe. Warm your bum. Warm your bum.
Get your arse off. This is not on this. Here come the police. Run away.
Leave your husband. Oh, I'm not married. Run. Warm your bum.
I'm typing in the word bum because I remember writing.
Right, you've got 38 seconds.
Oh. That ain't. That is not. It changed. It changed. I'm pretty sure it changes.
So I've done them all.
You finished?
They all told me things not to do with watch out for stuff. Come on, check the ear.
I definitely wrote home. Right, that's bollocks. That apparently is home in Wingdings.
You've got 1 minute left.
I can't do this instruction.
What does it say?
Who in your pants?
What's the problem?
Well, this, it'll come out, won't it? What's the word? Would it bifurcate into two separate poos?
You've got 5 seconds, John.
Yep.
Done.
John, I put it to you, you're not in this for the win.
I think Wingdings changes every time you use it.
I don't think that can be true.
That's true. That's the Enigma machine. Yes.
Joker man's seat, is that an instruction?
The task didn't say the signs had to be instructions.
No, it's exactly what it said.
It was quite an arse theme within your response, Fern. You warmed your bum 3 times successfully, and then you said a word that I wasn't aware of. Bifurcation.
Yeah.
Did you know about bifurcation?
I did know about bifurcation.
Did you?
Yeah.
You went to Cambridge.
I went to a college. So... Dara.
Yes.
What I wrote down is Dara's reaction to seeing high-value kidnappers, tigers, the Gruffalo, is identical. Dara looked like he did a lot, but it's percentage, isn't it?
It's percentage. Dara did all 100% of his. He did 25 out of 25. Fern managed to do 75% of her instructions. John, sort of half.
I couldn't read half of them, man.
OK, time for a break. For fun, why don't you ask your partner during the break if they'd like a nice cup of tea? If they say yes, scream into their face, tough, I would like to have been noticed for the last 15 years. See you after the break. Start of part two.
Yes, it is. And we're in the middle of a two-part task. They had to print and laminate lots of signs and then, unbeknownst to them, obey as many of them as possible. There are two people left. One is a human called Sarah, the other is a chihuahua called Munya. Here we go.
All right, so this should be fairly easy. This technology is just, like, breathing to me.
Print. Ooh, we're off. Ooh, I like the smell.
Go on, then.
You don't need to press anything.
Yeah, well, who out of both of us is likely to know more about technology? It's not doing much, is it? Oh, right, let me just put some of this on it. Oh. This is stressful. Why is it sweating? Get that back out. God for that.
So this is your very first lamination, is it?
It is. I mean, it might. Is it the best day of my life?
There's got to be some sort of fast setting on this.
Why would they have a fast setting?
Well, because in case you're in a rush. There you go.
Do you think the other guys will have already laminated?
Can you imagine Munya laminating?
No.
Where did you get this thing from, man? Look at what it's done to my sign.
I think you might have broken it when you pulled the thing through.
Wow.
How long have I got left?
You've got 30 seconds.
Come on! Faster, faster, faster!
Oh, my Lord!
Oh, no, what's... Is there more? Obey all of your...
All right. Alex stinks. Agree. I agree, Alex stinks.
Number one, go. Walk out of the door. There's a doorway.
Live. Doing it. Laugh. Be Leng. I mean, come on.
Oh, there's a door. Walk out the door. Turn around. Oh, I feel dizzy.
Be healthy, my bro. One, two.
Leave. Sod off. This is go away. This is bugger off.
Well, I did everything.
100%, you think?
Yeah.
Do eat that. Not eat that. Take your pants off. No way. Imagine that on the telly. Done.
Munya, with the wisdom of hindsight, would you say that the sentence, technology is like breathing to me, that the confidence there was misplaced?
No, because the thing is, it was ages, because I know to you guys a laminator is like a PS5, but for me, I'm used to the more, you know, the nippy stuff.
Can I ask a question? What's a PS5?
PlayStation.
Oh, for children. Yep.
It's like a...
So what you did, Sarah, was an extended mega mix of I Will Survive, the song.
Started off that way. Yeah. Just because I was trying to think of quick instructions.
Yeah, but it's nice because Gloria Gaynor should have been more aggressive. She should have said, go on, bugger off.
Sarah did a healthy number of instructions, 14, and obeyed 91% of them because she did not take her pants off.
She did not take her
pants
off.
No, didn't have any on, so, you know.
Whereas Munya managed to laminate 9 signs. He then obeyed all 9. There's 2 sets of scores, 1 for the amount of signs and 1 for the percentage obeyed. In the first half, John gets 1 point for his measly 7 signs, 2 to Munya, 3 for Sarah, 4 for Fern, 5 for Dara. And then, in terms of percentage obeyed, again, John only 1 point. 2 for Fern, 3 for Sarah, but Munya and Dara both get 5 points because they both obeyed 100% of their signs. So, that's how the scoring works!
Should we have a look at the scoreboard?
Yes. Well, unbelievably, John is at the bottom of the scoreboard with just 3 points. The leader has 5 times as many as him. That's Dara with 15 points.
Whoa! I'd like another task, please.
Yes, of course. And it's time to get your diving gear on and then go delving for grapes.
This is a lovely location.
You left-handed or right-handed, John?
Right-handed.
Put your hand right in there, please. Yeah. Perfect. There we go. Well, it's all yours. Good luck.
Oh, no.
And now I open the task?
Yes, please. Yeah.
Fucking Christ, here we go. Am I meant to read it with these on?
Yeah, I can give you a hand if you want.
Yeah, that'd be fab. Nice, fantastic. Just lay that down for me.
Would you just do that last bit there?
Oh, sure, yeah. It's quite easy. You just pop it open.
Can I take them off?
Before the task, yeah, if you want.
Put five grapes in the little bowl.
You've got 5 minutes.
You must wear the flippers as gloves for the entire 5 minutes.
The most flour still on the plate after 5 minutes wins.
Your time starts now.
Come on, let's crack on.
Yeah, it's an old sort of grandmother's game. We used to play this with my grand, but instead of flour, she used butter instead of grapes, wasps, and instead of flippers, we had to use our eyelids. And we're going to start with some good old-fashioned S&M. It's Sarah and Munya. Here we go.
Nothing around, nothing under the table.
Aha! Because the thing is, you want me to dig into the flour. I can see there's a little grape holder underneath.
It's a messy one, though. Yay!
Mm. Oh, there's no grapes in there. Crap.
No grapes in the grape holder.
What happens if they drop the grapes on the floor? Nothing.
All the information on the task.
It's covered in flour now, look.
OK, right. I'm just going to get all the flour off.
Different tactic. I can't tell if this is the worst idea you've ever seen or if I'm actually a genius.
Right, now, one grape.
This is how I cook. Like that.
One grape.
Two. Boom. Quick.
Two grapes.
Thanks.
Three grapes.
Do you know what I've just realised? Because most flour wins, isn't it?
There's another little bugger. Here he is. Hello.
Five grapes.
Right, so now all I need to do is get all the flour back on the plate.
Where is the plate?
Here.
Do I have to do anything else?
I'm going to pour the table over it.
Great.
Flour.
45 seconds.
Yes!
Most flour left. Oh, no!
Yes!
Should have read that. Should have covered it in flour. Thanks, Alex.
Pleasure. Five nice grapes. You can leave whenever you like. You can leave the garage now.
All right.
Oh, so push.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, look at all these grapes. Oh! Oh, damn it!
Fuck that one up.
Yeah, so it was get five grapes in the bowl, but it's measuring the amount of flour that's still on the plate afterwards. And Munya had 2,514 grams. Sarah, just 900 grams of flour.
Who's next?
Next up, it's Fern time and it's Kern time.
Are they hidden in the ceiling? Is there grapes behind me or something?
Just got to go like that, don't you? Pan for grapes. I mean, they're not like...
They could be...
Yeah, all right.
They could have been under there.
Well, hang on. Just got to...
Regrets.
One grape.
Yes. This is like doing surgery, isn't it? A lot of surgeons are alcoholics, so it probably feels like they have big hands on an especially pissed day.
Two grapes.
Mm-hmm. They're doing it on an old person because they're very dry and desiccated, so their bodies are just like flour.
You've got 1 minute 45 left, then.
Come on, we gotta save this old person!
You're still one grape short.
No, I'm trying to find it.
I can put flour back on the plate, can't I?
Okay.
That's the idea.
10 seconds.
No!
Come on,
I need a bit of moisture.
I'm too tired to keep going. She's gone. I did everything I could, though. Let me out.
Some interesting statistics about the medical community, Fern. Oh,
yeah. Because sometimes if a task felt boring, I had to pretend I was helping a person or an animal to get through it. This one, it made sense to pretend I was operating on an old person.
Yeah. And to be fully emotionally engaged with their death as well. Yeah. Their poor, desiccated skin falling away. John, I hate to repeat the questions I ask you, but are you not wanting to win any of it?
I just...
Yeah, what that picture doesn't show is that I've got flippers for fucking hands.
He did pretty well. He got nearly 2 kilograms of flour on the plate at the end, twice as much as Sarah.
Oh, I do apologise, John. That's quite enough for now. A welcome chance for us all to have a quick stop and a plop. One wet, one dry, fresh as a daisy for part three. See you soon! Taskmaster, can you give me an update, please, Alex?
Yes, Greg. The cast were wearing flippers on their hands whilst trying to find 5 grapes and pop them into a little bowl. The most flour on the plate at the end wins, one person left to see. And it's Dara O'Brien.
If there's some sense of where they were, that would be a help. Is there any way in which I can do this in a way which is salvageable?
Oh, no! Oh, it's on a cup!
Oh, that's not nice. Okay, hang on, let me just do this, right? Somewhere within this, there's still grapes. Are there grapes? Would somebody lie about the grapes?
Oh, that would be the worst thing in the world.
Oh. Put 5 grapes in a little bowl, you've 5 minutes.
Can I go to the kitchen, please?
OK.
Ah, that's also me! Grapes, 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 grapes.
Seconds.
Well, it doesn't say exactly 5 grapes.
It'd be nice, though, wouldn't it?
You will go.
10 seconds.
Five grapes, flour.
I went on such a journey during that. He was trying to work it out, and then, from the arrogant flick of the egg cup onto the floor onwards, he became a supervillain. He actually went, at one point, as he worked it out. Brilliant.
I don't know how he didn't notice the grapes, which were this far from his eyes.
He was too busy laughing into the night sky.
Scoring-wise, Fern didn't get 5 grapes, so does she get any points?
Oh. She was so tired.
Well, she was in there for 5 minutes.
Oh.
Is that all I did? Oh, no.
She didn't fulfil the task. She can't have any points.
OK, so 0 to Fern. Yeah. Sarah came 4th, so gets 2 points. John is 3rd, so gets 3 points. I can tell you, Munya, 2,514 grams. Dara, 2,903 grams. So Dara gets a 5 points.
Nice. One more, I think.
Yes, and this one involves something you've broken a lot of, Greg, running machines. Let's go. No.
Hello, Fern.
Hiya.
Got your buckets?
Yeah.
You look nice.
Oh, thanks. Yeah.
OK, get ready to receive the task. Are you acting?
Sort the ducks and socks.
Ducks go in the front bucket, obviously.
Socks go in the back bucket. Ducks, socks, ducks, socks.
All ducks and socks must travel along both treadmills, then fall directly into the correct bucket.
If a duck or sock lands on the floor, you may not retrieve it.
I'm not sure I could get down with these on.
Most ducks and socks in correct bucket wins.
There is a pair of bonus points. Oh, a proper point for the most correctly paired socks.
You have 15 minutes.
Your time starts now. Duck socks.
It's a bog standard game of double bucket, duck and sock.
Yes, it is.
I propose that we just get going.
Well, first we're going to see the self-proclaimed task mistress, Fern Brady, and the self-proclaimed John Kearns. John Kearns, here we go.
Where are the ducks and socks?
Not far off.
Right. So yeah. You've got to run round.
Well, I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Well.
Well, there's a duck. Does this count?
Yeah, I guess so. One.
And.
You. Wow.
Ducks in the front.
Ah, yes, that's a pair.
Well, what dropped then? Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Well, what dropped? What the fuck's in that? You.
They're not hidden.
Well, but they are, though.
Well.
Are they in the bath? Oh, no!
There's a duck in the sock! How small is he? You can't buy them that small.
Right.
Come on!
Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not bad at this, that's the thing.
Mm.
Oh, hang on. Can I slow it down? Here we go!
3.5 minutes left, John.
Oh, they all died. Would you like to see me get a sock and a duck? One, two.
I would love that.
Go on, crack on with it. You absolute wanker!
Oh, well.
Oh.
There's only socks in that one.
Yes.
And there's only socks in that one.
There's a duck in that one, maybe it'll be.
Oh, one duck, one duck.
I wrote some quotes down that you said during your attempt. What the fuck is that? Did you hear that? Well, what dropped? You can't even buy them that small.
You know, you can't buy them that small. Well, I bought my son one a month ago.
But did you try and get a really small one? Did you do extensive research into the smallest duck you can buy?
There is only one size of duck. I don't know what the fuck they were. I'd have looked mad if I'd gone up to the pharmacist and gone, sorry,
pharmacist?
Do you have...
a prescription duck.
Yeah. Yeah. Where are you buying ducks at the pharmacy?
Why are you buying ducks in a pharmacy?
Well, where else do you buy them?
At least John found the ducks very quickly, whereas Fern thought we'd hidden the ducks and the socks, and she put a crown on and said she was the mother of the ducks.
Yeah. I did create a narrative where I was the mother of the ducks, saving them.
And some of them died.
Some of them died. died, yes. But most of them were rescued.
Yes, she did rescue 44 ducks in her duck bucket.
OK.
And 13 socks. So she had a total of 57 things in her bucket.
Wow.
John, 9 socks, 1 duck, no pairs. OK, 2 more duck and sock sorters now. It's Munya and Sarah.
Are they all in here?
Right, we'll start with the ducks.
Oh, no, you put them inside! This duck is like the socks! Oh, this is going to take ages!
You caught them.
Right, we're going to move on to socks now.
Great.
Hold on. I can't see my pockets because of my tits. Sorry.
You can't see your pockets.
I can't see my pockets.
Because, yeah.
What the hell? I didn't get any in. If they fall on the floor, then you're not allowed to pick them up.
Correct.
Oh, well.
One at a time is better.
How many did I get? 1. Well, the joke's on you because I get to go again.
How long have I got left, please?
You haven't got long. 2.5 minutes.
I didn't ask for an opinion. I just asked for a time.
So no more opinions.
Sock bomb, sock bomb. This is how I used to make footballs in Zimbabwe. How long?
8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Did I do it?
I mean, if I'm honest, I don't know what I thought, because all I can hear is I can't see my pockets because of my tits.
It happens more often than you'd think.
Well, I've got a similar problem. The Zimbabwe sock football was a colossal failure.
Well, it did lead to a disaster of many ducks falling out as he fell in.
So I should have been good at that task, because when I was a kid, I used to practice balancing in the bath by covering it in Vaseline. So,
hang on. Whoa.
So you cover the bath in Vaseline and then you see how long you can stand up for. It's a game. So what? You never played games in the bath?
Yeah, I played games.
Like what kind?
You know.
That's not a game. What you're thinking?
Tell me.
It's not a game.
See if you can use elastic bands to make it look like a submarine. Right. Thank God, it's break time. When we come back, someone edges closer to winning Munya's dead plant and Dora's dead knee. Yes. See you soon. Welcome back to the final part of tonight's show.
Yes, it's been a great night, and I really think that's down to you, Sarah, Munya, Dara and Fern being on top form. Before the break, the comics were busy sorting out ducks and socks, but there's still one person left to see. So here we go. It's the host of Sock the Beak. It's Dara O'Brien. Thank you, everyone.
Now, also the key is to pair up the socks before you send them down.
Oh, this is not the fun bit.
Oh, I want the fun bit. Ooh, here we go. Can we put a bag of ducks down? A bag for ducks? Can I get a bag, please?
There's an element of gamble to this.
If this goes wrong, this is calamitous. Same plastic bags. Wow, they all paired.
They're all paired.
This is a big moment.
How do you want me to do this?
Oh! You made 2 or 3 references to just wanted to get on with the fun bit.
The kneeling on the ground, taking ducks from socks, that's not fun. That's not fun at all. That's a non-fun thing. Watching the ducks go on 2 treadmills, I could have done that all day.
Hit me with some numbers.
Well, obviously, John, in last place, 1 point. Fern got a total of 57. Sarah, 58. So she's in third place. Munya got 37 socks compared to Dara's 28, but the ducks fell out. So we only ended up with 29 ducks compared to Dara's 63 ducks. What's more, Dara was the only person who paired more than two socks. He paired a total of 28 socks, 14 pairs. So he gets two bonus points as well. So that's 7 points in total to Dara Green. It's amazing. Yeah.
OK, it's time for you all to head to the stage for the final task of the show! Raise the curtain! Alex, who's going to read the task out?
Sarah Millican is going to read the task out.
Commence.
Make the Taskmaster say your words. Each team will ask one question at a time and each question must be made up of exactly six words. Also, each team member must take it in turns to say two words of each question. First to make the Taskmaster say your word wins.
Dara, which of these would you like to be your first word? This one, you take that one, please.
Thank you.
You can show it to your team and you can show it to the audience. So that one is for this team. Sarah, you're going to go first.
Thank you.
You cannot talk tactics with your teammate at all, but it is a team task. OK, so we're going to start with a team of three. Dara will commence the question. Here we go. Good luck.
What wriggles...
in... oh, Greg's?
John, to complete the question.
Muddy garden.
What wriggles in Greg's muddy garden?
Worm.
Very good. So, to stop this team winning round one, you need to get it in one. Good luck.
What breakfast...
is long...
and meaty?
Sausage.
OK, so round one is a tie. We move to round two. We're going to go slightly harder words. There we go. So this time, let's start with a team of two. Munya, you're going to kick off the question.
Can you...
No more words.
Lessen erection.
Please finish off the question, Munya.
Until it's...
Right, well, that's the end of the question. Greg, the question is, can you lessen erection until it's...
soft?
Not right. Your turn, team of three.
How would...
you describe...
enormous hugeness?
Massive.
So the team of three win round two. It's currently 2-1. Good luck, everyone. John, you're going to start the question this time.
I wish...
not to.
I wish not to.
yeah, somehow turn this into a question, please, Dara. And also, make it relevant to the word somehow.
ascend vertically.
So the question is, I wish not to ascend vertically.
Descend?
It's weirdly not right, so it's Sarah to start.
What trousers...
do farmers...
wear now?
Well, it's either, just to tee it up, it's either dungarees or overalls. What do they wear now? That's what's thrown me. Overall.
You've gone for overall, it's not right. So it's a team of three again.
Which aircraft...
crashes more...
John, would you mind finishing off the question?
It's easy.
Into mountains.
Helicopter.
Wow. This is to draw this round.
Not overalls.
So it...
must be...
dungarees.
So the team of three win three, the team of two win two.
Marvellous. Let's put that to the final scores. Come down and join me.
Easy one to score. The team of three got 3 points, the team of two got 2 points. Are you happy with that?
Yes, please.
That's nice and easy, but it does mean the final scores. It's a clean sweep, a huge 30 points in one episode, and that's, of course, Mr. Dara O'Brien.
Very nice. Dara wins. Please go and gather your things, never to be thrown away. What have we learned today? We've learned that people come in different shapes and sizes, but not ducks. No, ducks come in one size and one size only. And if you've got an issue with that fact, you better speak to this guy. Bye-bye, everyone. You can go now, but don't forget who won tonight. It was Dara O'Brien!
Well, Alex Brooker's task tonight, give gliding a go to see if that can be his brand new hobby. That's at 11:05. But next here on Channel 4, John Richardson is out to avoid 70s sitcom stereotypes while simultaneously ensuring that his mother-in-law doesn't move in with him.